If I could have your attention in the media center, we're going to start our post-race media availability. We're now joined by three of our four contenders. Noah Gragson, driver of the number 18 Safelite Auto Glass Toyota. Johnny Sauter, driver of the number 21 ISM Connect Chevrolet. And Justin Haley, driver of the number 24 Fraternal Order of Eagles Chevrolet. If you have a question, please raise your hand and we'll get you a mic. We'll start here in the corner.
Justin Schuler, Speedway Media. Noah, you had a couple restarts at the front. Did you have a preference or did you see any kind of advantage with the inside versus outside?
I don't know. The second to last one I restarted, I was running second, and I had to restart on the outside. And I'm thinking, man, I don't know why you choose the bottom as the leader with all the speedy dry down, just because there's not a lot of grip and there wasn't a lot of grip down there. So was able to prevail in that restart with about 14 to go and on the outside. And so I'm like, hell yeah, man, like this thing's rocking and rolling now. We're looking at victory lane, and my good buddy Riley Herp spun out or something, and we had to restart again on the outside. And I really thought I ran the scenarios through my head. I thought, man, the 98's probably going to body slam me down in one and two on the first lap if I take the outside. If I take the inside, I'm going to be put three wide middle just the way the motors are with the 16 having the open motor. So really we were in a lose-lose position. And ended up taking the top, and the 98 got split by the 16, and we ended up getting body slammed. But I don't know. I guess it's just hard racing, short track racing. You know. Most importantly, we're gonna be racing for a championship next weekend, and I know my crew guys, everybody at Kyle Busch Motorsports on the Safelite Auto Glass team, they definitely earned it. Safelite Auto Glass. It's gonna be their first time at Homestead next year or next weekend. So really excited.
We'll go up front.
Johnny, there was a point in the race where you got on the radio and just said this is embarrassing. Sorry. You said this was embarrassing. What was going on with your truck that you just really couldn't seem to get any momentum going forward?
Yeah, I mean, we just struggled all day from the word go right off the truck. No balance, loose, and you tried to work that out of it, and then it would just get to plowing. And so at the beginning of the race, I was sideways, and we made one round of wedge in the left rear, and it went to just absolutely chattering through the front tires. And so we took that back out, and then the last half of the race, we were sideways again. So just no balance, no grip. So I'm not sure what we're doing or what we're not doing, but we kind of sucked at Texas, and we kind of sucked tonight. So if we do that again next week, it won't be good.
And what was the final diagnosis on your truck, Justin?
Just an oil line. Broke, got cut, soft line, just from a piece of debris hit it. I do not have plans for next year. Obviously, chasing the championship is going to be helpful. And if we get the championship, it'll try to secure what I... Some of the stuff I got working for next year, I'm not going to be sitting on the couch. I hope not, but nothing to announce right now.
We'll go next to Chris and then to Bob.
Yeah, Chris Knight, CatchLens.com for any three. This looks like to potentially be the strongest championship four field we've had in a long time. And how do you guys feel about the race itself, intense-wise, race-wise? We'll see you next week in Homestead.
Depends on, you know, what they're going to do for engines. If it's a race like tonight where you've got built motors running against spec motors, who the hell knows? I mean, it's a joke. You know, I got nothing good to say about it. It's embarrassing. So you race with guys with built motors, and they just drive away from you here. So if they do that next week, who knows what the advantage will be. Torque is a huge advantage at a place like that, and gear. I like to call it torque multiplication. So, you know. We'll just go down there and race our tails off and see what happens.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with Johnny on the motor thing. When Elmore runs sim, you know, through the motors, everything's pretty accurate. You know, in qualifying, we're very close, but we get 20, 30 laps into the race, and the 16 truck had a built motor. The 19, Derek Krause, it's his first race, had a very strong truck. So on places that wear tires, and tonight and especially next weekend at Homestead, there's going to be a lot of tire wear. It's going to be game over for us guys in Elmore. So we only can do as much as we can.
Yeah, I'm just excited for my team to have the opportunity to race for a championship, and we're going to work hard this week to do the best job we can do, and we're going to go down fighting, that's for sure.
Bob Pockris, ESPN, I have two. First for Johnny, considering the season that you've had, have you just kind of been waiting in some ways for Homestead? Have you just, because you knew, I would think that you'd have a good shot of getting there and vying for the title?
Well, I mean, obviously you put your best effort forth every week, you know, to try to, you know, even though we won Martinsville, we went to Texas and tried to do our best, and we came here tonight trying to do our best, and the last 2 weeks have been a struggle, like I mentioned. So, yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, when you win the first race of the year, you got a chance to race for a championship because you're pretty much locked in the playoffs. So, you know, having said that, it's been a great season, and six wins has been great. And you almost sit here and say, if you don't get the championship, it's a disappointment. But there's three other guys that want to win the championship as well. So we got to go down there you know, do our best. And I hope we're the guys holding the championship trophy, but you just never know.
And for Noah, there was some talk before this weekend that people might take some pretty aggressive chances at the finish because it's in the turn. And if you don't necessarily want your truck for next year, you can be pretty bold. Did you have any thoughts or think if you were close enough to the lead that you would do something that maybe we hadn't seen?
I don't know. It wasn't really on my radar, just scenario-based, so it didn't happen. So I don't know. I can't really make a comment on it.
Been next to Jerry.
Jerry Jordan, kicking the tires, letting it in PRN. For all y'all, but first with Johnny, you know, you do strike the fear into hearts of some drivers out there on the track because you are known to be aggressive and to you go for the win. Are you hoping that helps your advantage next week going into Homestead and that you're going all out? And for the other guys, are they worried about, you know, going up against a wily veteran like that?
Oh, I'm scared. I mean, I'm on the edge of my seat trying to race Johnny every week.
I was going to say, I think these guys couldn't give a crap less. So, and I know if I was them, I wouldn't either. So, you know, to be honest with you, I'm not even worried about these guys. I mean, I know that I have to worry about myself and worry about my truck and get it driving and get the balance as best as I can. And if we do that and we race right and race smart all night, we should have a good shot at it. And I think at the end of the day, if you go down there and you put your best effort forth and you come up short, that's just the way it is. You know, last year was one spot short, 1 point. And, you know, you do your best and it sucks, but that's the way it is. You know what I mean? But I don't think these guys could care less about, you know, me racing hard because everybody races hard all the time.
Go ahead.
Question for Johnny. You just said earlier the other guys were driving away from you. Does it mean your engine lost power?
Yeah, I mean, I felt like I was soft all night under the hood, and I have no problem saying that, you know. But, you know, when you're racing against built engines that obviously can turn a lot more RPMs and they have an advantage shifting, you come to a place like this, you know, that's an advantage. So these guys can both tell you. I mean, you race against it. You can get a run on a guy, be way faster than a guy, and if he's shifting, it's really, really hard to get by him. So at least it was for me. But, you know, obviously I wasn't handling the greatest tonight, so it was probably a little bit harder for me. But, you know, that's just kind of some of the things that we've dealt with all year, and that's the way it's been. So this is nothing new. It's kind of been a problem at some places throughout the course of the year.
We'll go next to Lee, and then here.
Engine aside, though, as strong as your team has been this season, are you genuinely concerned going into Homestead? I mean, just with how your team's performed over the last, you know, you mentioned last week and this week, are you genuinely concerned about your team as a whole going into Homestead?
Well, I mean, I feel like the truck that we're taking is a truck that we've been kind of saving. it's a really good truck, and it's very well balanced, and we've had some success with that truck this year. So
where'd you run it?
Vegas was the last time we ran it. So having said that, I feel good about the setup package there. I mean, it's going to be what I consider a more traditional type setup stuff. So concerned, I'm always concerned, me personally, because, you know, I've won races and I'm still concerned. You know what I'm saying? That's just my nature. But, you know, you can't ever count anybody out. You know what I'm saying? That's what makes racing so crazy and exciting to watch sometimes, is you just never know what's going to happen. So you can go down there and have everything going your way, and a valve stem could fall out of the wheel with 10 laps to go. So those are the things that, you know, you think about, and those are things that you can't control ultimately. But you just never let your guard down, or at least I don't. And I feel like it's been working out pretty good for us. But I feel like we're hitting on all 8 cylinders. We've got a great group of guys. I got a great team. And we'll get it right.
Christian Coley, frontstretch.com, right over here. This question's for all three of you. Y'all, the series was the first ones to get to run on the new layout of Phoenix Raceway. Can you comment on what you thought of the new layout, and if you liked it, and if you think it should go back to the old one?
Well, we're not really going to change anything, so it was great.
Kathy Brown pitting outside the box. Noah, you had that one stop during the race that looked like it was going to be a disaster for you.
It was a disaster.
Yeah. But on the radio, you stayed so calm and so focused, and it was so uncharacteristically, easy word for me to say, you. And even now, you just seem so monotone. You should be so excited you're running for a championship, but yet you just don't seem like the normal Noah. What's going on?
I'm just execution focused on what I got to do next weekend.
Are there any final questions? All right. Thank you for joining us, gentlemen, and good luck next weekend. All right, if I could have your attention in the media center, we're going to continue our post-race media availability. We're now joined by the race-winning team, Brett Moffitt, driver of the number 16, Kobe Toyota, and crew chief Scott Zipidelli, and team owner Shiggy Hattori. We're going to open it up to questions. If you have a question, please raise your hand. We'll get you a mic. We'll start here with Matt.
Matt Weaver with Auto Week. This question's for Scott. I hate to go back to a familiar topic, but the last press conference we had in here, the GMS guys had suggested that if you guys were to bring the OEM motor, that they would be toast. And I'm curious if you guys made up your mind which motor you would bring yet and what goes into that process.
Well, they didn't have very good trucks today. Honestly. I would love to stir the pot right now, because that's all they do is whine about our engines. But if you look at the race itself, we kill them through the corners. Our truck drives better than our truck. The engine has some advantages in some spots. All I'll say is, yes, it does rev higher. But it only revs higher when you're shifting from second, third, and fourth. Once you get in high gear, it does not rev any higher.
On a similar and more positive note, just the pride in being able to win maybe one more race for the OEM motor.
I'm very proud of it. It's a great piece. It's a proven piece. That's all I can say is, you know, we swapped engines last week and went to Texas and qualified, I think, best than we've qualified all year, qualified fourth and finished third. So I think this team is strong enough to perform at the top level with either piece. We picked the OEM engine beginning of the year based off of the rule books, and the rule books changing, and we have to adapt to that. Can't thank Mark Cronquist and TRD enough for all that they've done for us and give us great pieces, but we had a really good truck today. And the engine is one major component of the whole package.
We'll go ahead with Chris.
ChrisKnightCatchments.com. Brett, are you the favorite to win the championship next week?
Yeah, I think we've proven all year we are. You know, at Martinsville, I got asked, well, I mean, maybe not the favorite, but we're right there with Johnny. At Martinsville, I got asked if we were a dark horse, and I said, well, we have the second most wins, and now we're only one back. So now we're locked into Homestead. I will say the beginning of the chase didn't go as planned for us. We weren't executing the races to 100%, but the last two or three races, I feel like we've done a great job of that, and it's shown in the results. We have a second, a third, and a win in the last three races. So I think we can go to Homestead and execute.
And Chiggy, your investment that you've made, spent millions of dollars and trial and error and sponsors after sponsors, you now get the opportunity to run for a championship. What does that mean to you and your organization?
Well, definitely that's big for our sponsors. And they spend a lot of money. Then they trust all the team and then myself. And one of the main sponsors, Kobe, the president, was here. And that's so big for us.
What's the sponsor next week at Homestead?
Icing.
We're next to Bob.
Bob Hocker, ESPN. Brett, does it matter next Friday, the fact that you won here today, or if you had finished third?
No. You know, it's... I'm not going to just run third if I can have a shot at a win. You know, I still want to get as many wins on the season as possible, but, you know, for sure we're locked in now, and if we would have finished third, we would have had our heads held high also. So, you know, next Friday, it's the pressure's off, the gloves are off, and we just got to go out there and fight and execute and try to win a race. I think it's going to take a race win to win the championship, and that's what we need to do.
Lee and Reed.
Lee Spencer, RacingBoys.com. Brett, you said in your radio interview that this was like your second coming, so to speak. Can you kind of talk about having the opportunity to do what you've been able to do this year?
Yeah, you know, 2015, I kind of fell into a cup ride, I guess, from just my testing and, you know, the companies I was aligned with. And it wasn't race-winning equipment. And so at the end of that year when MWR shut down, it kind of put me – out of a job, and I've been bounced around ever since. And then, you know, fortunately this year I was able to work with Shiggy and drive for his race team, which he's built a great race team. And, you know, I think it really shows what I can do as a driver as well. And, you know, you're not going around there running 30th, 25th in the cup races. You're actually winning races and competing for championships, which is what I need to be doing. And it's not really about what series I'm in. It's about winning.
And Scott, when I guess after Brett did his burnout, somebody said, go ahead, destroy it, we'll get you a new one next year. You know, his status has kind of been up in the air for next year. I mean, can either
one of you... Reading deep.
I'm sorry?
No, just reading deep.
Well, that's what we do. You know, is there any change as far as what Brett's status is, either one of you, for next year?
I think for all of us sitting at this table, we're focused on next week. I don't know what I'm doing next year. We all have a plan, what we'd like to do. But in this sport, you don't really know what you're doing until you know what you're doing. So right now, we're focused on winning the championship. And obviously, I mean, I love this team. This is the most fun I've had in racing in the last 25 years. Guys work 7 days a week with a smile on her face the past 3 weeks to get to this point. I would sign up to do this for many years to come with this group, Brett driving and Shiggy Hattori owning it. But like I say, we're trying to get through today, and then trying to get through Friday, and then hopefully Friday we get this thing knocked out of the park and we'll all be in good shape.
That's a good question, but you know, all our sponsors are so happy now, and then they won't continue next year, but still we don't know yet. And Scott asked, you know, more budget every week, and right?
Yeah, I do.
Reed Spencer with NASCAR Wire. Brett, can you describe the winning move and how that set up for you?
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't sure if I wanted a caution to come out there or not. In hindsight, I did. But, you know, where we were sitting, we were locked into Homestead mathematically. And when that caution came out, I was kind of nervous. I didn't know what was going to happen. And then when the 18 took the top, I really didn't know what the hell was going to happen. I was just hoping the 98 got rolling to where he didn't stack up the inside. And fortunately, he did. He got a good restart, and I dove down to the apron, and our truck was actually really good running the actual apron through one and two all night long. I made a lot of passes there, so I just kind of stuck it down there and went for it, and we were able to clear off two and drive away.
Two questions. Wolfgang Monser, Rennsport Press Agency from Germany. One for Mr. Arturi, and then the other for Scott Cipardelli. Pun?
The last two times he said Greg.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, then a first question for you. You said earlier that from certain gears, when you shift higher, the engine is revving higher, as when I understood it correctly. Is there not a possibility, or maybe a risk? Risk is maybe the better word, to overreef the engine?
Yeah, there's always a risk in that. This engine operates at a higher RPM. You're capable of going to a higher RPM where the NT1 engine stops at 7,500, it hits the chip. We can go a little bit higher than that. Through gear changes.
And the second question from Mr. Arturi, with your success in American NASCAR racing, you think maybe that brings more involvement over from Japan to NASCAR, either team ownership or driver?
Well, you know, I moved to U.S. this year, 23 years, but still in Japan, they don't know about NASCAR. Then my next project, I show NASCAR more over in Japan, bring more sponsor to here. That's next my project. But this year, we're so successful year. Definitely, that's big help for our sponsor and all NASCAR into Japan.
Are there any final questions for our race winning team? Go up front to Chris.
Scott, what truck are you bringing next weekend to Homestead, and where did you race it, and why are you bringing that specific truck?
We're bringing truck 7 to Homestead. We last ran it at Vegas, and we've spent quite a bit of time on it, on updating it and getting it ready to go to Miami Homestead. Not for any particular reason other than it was a truck that was, we've run it a lot. We've won races with all of our trucks, actually. But this truck took out of rotation and did some updates to it. And we've been working on it for the past 3-4 weeks just to get it ready for Miami.
Jerry Jordan, KickingTheTires.net and PRN. Shiggy, for you, I want to follow up on what your comment about your sponsor. Kuba Toyo Pit is what, when you're bringing these sponsors from Japan to America, what has been their reaction and their response to NASCAR racing and their investment, obviously, to put your trucks on the track? How has that paid off for them, and what is their continued influence in the sport?
Well, they don't have any business in U.S. And then first one, they tried to help my team, but now, you know, the president, he was here today, and then he's really, really interested in this sport. And then, so, but he's thinking in the future, they start something business over in the U.S. So then I think that's paid off.
Any final questions? All right. Thank you, gentlemen, and congratulations.